Magnesium is a cofactor in more than 300 enzyme systems in the body, which is a lot of work and responsibility that magnesium has for being just a mineral. And when you hear that more than 50% of the population in the US don't get the recommended daily amount of magnesium, you begin to wonder why the food supply in the US is so deficient in magnesium. Why is our food lacking so many nutrients? To the point that you wonder what the drawbacks of a magnesium deficiency can be and what signs and symptoms play out when the levels of magnesium in our body are too low. This video is gonna address all that, but in a different way. You find a lot of people on YouTube throwing out a bunch of different symptoms of magnesium deficiency without really giving you a perspective, or let's say a timeline, of what happens first. What's early or what's too late? This video will be different. You'll know exactly what are the early signs that tend to happen first. Then I'll get into the intermediate progression of the deficiency. Then lastly, the more severe symptoms that play out with magnesium deficiency to really help bring clarity and make sense of it all. So stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you see an Arsalan Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. As you guys already know, this channel is really all about helping you make more informed decisions about your health and wellness. I'm posting 3 times a week on this channel now, so consider hitting that red subscribe button down below to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Also, if you guys learned anything in the video, give it a like down below too, as it'll seriously make my day and it'll help you get this video recommended by YouTube. Let's start with the big picture. What does magnesium do? We mentioned that magnesium is involved in over 300 enzyme systems. Well, some of the major roles it plays out is protein synthesis, muscle and nerve function, blood glucose control, and blood pressure regulation, to name a few. And an adult body contains approximately 25 grams of magnesium, with 50 to 60% of that being in the bones, and most of that, the rest of that being in the soft tissue. Only less than 1% of total magnesium is actually in the blood serum, and these levels are kept under tight control by the kidneys. In fact, about 2,400 milligrams of magnesium passes through the kidneys daily, of which 5% of this is passed along through the urine, which I'll come back to in a bit. So you can tell that it becomes really difficult when it comes to testing magnesium in your body, because you're only measuring the magnesium in the blood and not the total magnesium in the body, which is why the next thing to look for are the signs and symptoms of what is known as hypomagnesemia, or low magnesium. Let's start out with the earlier signs first. Symptoms of magnesium deficiency tend to be non-specific, so medical professionals may suspect other conditions or deficiencies, as some of these symptoms can actually cross over as other deficiencies in vitamins and minerals as well, so keep that in mind. The first one that usually starts off is a loss of appetite. So if you're not hungry, consider whether your diet is missing any important nutrients like magnesium. Secondly, you get nausea, which may trigger vomiting more than usual. Now, because this is usually an early symptom, it may not be present in everyone. The third is fatigue and weakness, which makes sense, right? Because magnesium is required by the ATP synthesizing protein in mitochondria. ATP, the molecule that provides energy for almost all metabolic processes, exists primarily as a complex with magnesium. So it's not surprising that low magnesium levels can result in fatigue and feeling tired. So those are pretty much going to be the early signs: loss of appetite, nausea and vomiting, and fatigue and weakness. And remember, those are all non-specific to magnesium, as other conditions and deficiencies usually have the same early symptoms, and it's possible that you could also not even have any of the starting mild symptoms either. So that's why let's look at the intermediate symptoms now. What would come next? The next signs would be numbness and tingling. This is because magnesium plays such an important role in nervous system health and overall nerve function. That's why those who have low magnesium experience tingling in their toes and fingertips, or even their face. Another sign is muscle contractions and cramps. Now, this is because low magnesium lowers the electrical threshold at which nerve cells become depolarized, which makes them hyperexcitable. And when they become hyperexcitable, this leads to muscle cramping. The same is true for calcium, and low calcium levels can also cause the same muscle spasms as well. The next on the list can be an abnormal heart rhythm, like a rapid or irregular heartbeat, which can be the result of getting into that territory of actually chronically low magnesium levels. Because remember, magnesium is actually one of several electrolytes, including potassium, sodium, and calcium, that play a big part in regulating the electrical signals within your body and help your heart to function properly. When these electrolytes are imbalanced, they appear to have an effect on the rhythm of your heart, which can then be detected on the ECGs. The next on the list, and remember we are still in that intermediate zone for symptoms, is one that I found really interesting and that not a lot of people cover, and that is personality changes. You see, magnesium ions regulate calcium ion flow and neuronal calcium channels, and this helps to regulate neuronal nitric oxide production. That's the normal process. But in a magnesium deficiency, the neuronal requirements for magnesium may not be met, causing neuronal damage, which could then manifest as depression. So basically, to put all of what I just said simple, magnesium acts as the brake system of our nervous system, keeping us from being stuck in overdrive. Because the more you are in overdrive, the more others will see your personality has changed. You see, serotonin and melatonin have an effect on mood as well. Magnesium works as an important cofactor required for the conversion of tryptophan from the proteins we get from food to serotonin and melatonin. But poor gut health or lack of proper nutrition can cause an imbalance of production of these neurotransmitters, which may in turn make you anxious, depressed, and affect and change your personality. This all goes back to how important our diets are to our mental state. And a lot of that seems to be forgotten these days. So those are all the intermediate signs. The major signs, if you will, or the chronic magnesium deficiency symptoms are hypocalcemia, which means a calcium deficiency, or hypokalemia, which means a potassium deficiency. Now, both of these, if left unchecked, can lead to conditions like osteoporosis, and even heart disease. Now you might be thinking, how much magnesium do we need then? Adults need about 400 milligrams of magnesium per day. So choose foods such as spinach or other greens, nuts and seeds that are rich in magnesium, and other important nutrients. I'm gonna pull up a list that goes over some of the foods that are rich in magnesium. So take a look here, with some of my favorite ones being artichokes, parsley, and squash. And yes, that very well could be an unpopular opinion, but hey, you gotta start from somewhere, right? Click the red subscribe button down below and the bell next to it. Also, if this video gets enough likes, it'll let me know you enjoyed the video so I could do a part 2 on magnesium. Until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.